Hey everyone, this is Stephanie from Fast Track to Health Wellness Center coming to you live on a Sunday afternoon. And today is the last day for me in this kitchen that you see behind me. Tomorrow I will be without a kitchen for a few weeks because my kitchen is getting done over again because we had a flood a few months ago, so we're getting a new kitchen. So today's my last day in this kitchen. So in any case, I just wanted to let you know that. So I know this was another spontaneous Facebook Live, not planned, because it just seems easier for me to get around to them this way. You guys can always watch the replay if you miss it right now, not a problem. But in any case, I mentioned in a video that I posted earlier this week that I would be talking to you about the detox program that I want to do as a group coming up in a couple of weeks. So I wanted to give you some details in today's Facebook Live. If you do wind up joining in during this live stream, you can feel free to ask any questions, not a problem. So, you know, another weight loss tool that we use in our clinic is a detoxification program. And right now we're using a product from Standard Process, that's the main company that we use. So I'm gonna tell you all about that in this video. But prior to that, I want to get into a little bit of the background of detoxification. What is it? Why is it necessary? How do we do it? Et cetera, et cetera. So I'm gonna get into all of these questions today. So first and foremost, what exactly is detoxification? What does it mean? Well, basically it means it's the body's way of removing toxins and poisons through the body and eliminating them, neutralizing and eliminating them through the organs of elimination. So the liver, the kidneys, and the colon are ways that we eliminate toxins from our body. So our body is actually doing this whether we realize it or not on an ongoing basis. But the problem is, because we're overloaded with so many more toxins than we ever have been, it gets really difficult for the body to be able to do that on its own. And it requires a lot of nutrients to make it happen efficiently. So that's why doing some type of cleanse and using products to go along with it is very helpful. Now, there are other ways to detox, and we're gonna get into that as well. But today we're going to talk specifically about one that we do in our clinic. So that's the what. It's basically the body removing and eliminating toxins by making them first from fat-soluble toxins into water-soluble toxins and eliminating them through the organs of eliminations. So why is this important? Why is it important that we eliminate toxins from our body? Well, first and foremost, you have to remember that toxins are everywhere. We live in a very toxic world. So the world that we live in today is much different than it was, say, 100 years ago. So we are exposed to over 80,000 chemicals on a regular basis. That's a really high number. And toxins come from many different sources. So from the air that we breathe, the water that we drink, the food that we eat, the products that we use, not only on our skin and throughout our body, but the products that we clean with, the products that are just all around us, say in paint and throughout the household. There's just basically chemicals everywhere. It's unavoidable. No matter how much you try, it's almost impossible to avoid chemicals 100%. Even if you were to eat organic food and use natural products, you're still gonna be exposed to chemicals on a regular basis. And over time, the amount of chemicals and toxins that come into our bodies, they become a burden. The body is not able to eliminate them all very efficiently. And this eventually will lead to other problems. So chronic disease, you know, part of that is an accumulation of toxins over long periods of time. Now, on a symptom sort of basis, there's lots of ways that symptoms appear from having toxicity. So things like fatigue, joint pain, skin problems, allergies, digestive issues, all of these could be signs that the body has accumulated too many toxins. Okay, so these are just some of the things that you might feel when your body is overburdened with these things. Even things like heavy metals, that's another thing that gets into our body through a variety of ways. And these accumulate, and like I said, eventually lead to not only symptoms, but could eventually lead to full-blown chronic diseases. So it's really important that we help and enhance our body's natural detoxification process by doing some other things. Now, there are many different ways to help and enhance detoxification, and some of us are doing this anyway without even realizing it. So if you're eating a really clean diet, you're eating organic food, you're eating whole foods, you're not eating processed foods, that's a really great start because, you know, first and foremost, you're getting less chemicals in the food that you eat, and you're getting more nutrients in the food that you eat. And nutrients are really critical in helping eliminate the toxins. So that's a first step. Another thing that a lot of people are doing already is exercise. So that's a big one. So exercise is a natural way also to start to remove things from your body. Heat therapy, I'm really big on this. I love going in a sauna. And now that I have one back at my house again, I've been going in the sauna almost every day right after I work out. So that makes my sweat session even that much more intense. So that's been really great. And I've even noticed that I feel just like a little bit better than I already do from having the regular saunas incorporated back into my routine, especially right after exercise. So fasting, another thing that we talk about all the time in the group, fasting, that's a great way to detoxify. As a matter of fact, that's probably one of the best ways that you can detoxify. But for some people, it's difficult for them, or they haven't started to do any fasts yet. So that's another reason why I wanted to incorporate another tool like the one we'll talk about today, because some of you may already be doing some fasting, but maybe you're not doing it on a regular basis. So that's another reason why I wanted to incorporate this program, because you can continue to eat without fasting and also detoxify. But fasting in and of itself is one of the best ways, but it's also very intense. So, you know, if you were to fast for a period of time and you haven't done that before, as you're detoxifying, you're not going to feel very good. So it's very extreme, and it's, you know, not really for everybody. But I do encourage that people do that at least on a semi-regular basis, or if you're going to incorporate it into your daily lifestyle, you at least do intermittent fasting where you're eating in a shortened period of time. So then herbs, there's many different herbs that you can take that will help you eliminate toxins as well. So if you've been taking some herbal products, that's another way to detox your colon, to detox your kidneys, to detox your liver. So that's another great way. So these are just some strategies that people can incorporate in addition to the thing that we're going to talk about today. What's great about this product that we're going to use is that it incorporates a few of the things together. So you're going to be eating a clean diet while you're doing the detox, and you're going to be helping the organs of elimination, the colon, the kidneys, and the liver, do a better job of getting things out. So it's sort of like a multi-level type of detoxification process. So that's why it's so powerful. And it's something that I recommend that my patients do at the bare minimum once a year. I've been doing it at least once a year for a while. This product that we're going to talk about today is actually new for the company that we're using, Standard Process. In the past, we've done one called the Purification Program from them, which was a 21-day cleanse. But now they have a new product out that does not require you to take any pills. Everything is just in the shakes. So it's a new way of doing it. It makes it a lot easier for people. They don't have any pills to swallow, and it just makes it a lot simpler. And they've also made it into two lengths of time. They have a 10-day program, and they have a 28-day program. So which one you need to do really depends on a number of factors. One way is to figure out what your level of toxicity is. So it comes with a questionnaire, and I'm going to link below directly to the website where you can take the questionnaire yourself, so you could see what your symptoms are and how high your score is. And then you could let me know what your score is, and I could tell you whether you'd be better off doing the 10-day or the 28-day. But basically, you know, the more burdened you are, more toxic you are, perhaps the more weight you want to lose, the more likely you're going to want to do the 28-day. However, since I really want to do this as a group activity, I'm going to encourage people to do the 10-day, because then I think more people will be inclined, especially if they've never done this before, to do a 10-day over a 28-day. So that's what I'm encouraging everyone to do, is to join in on the group effort of the 10-day detox. And we are going to start this at the end of March as a group on Saturday, March 30th. The reason I'm starting it on a Saturday is because the first couple days, you're kind of getting used to it. You may not feel so great right away. So it's better if you're starting on a weekend and you're not at work. So we're going to encourage you to start on a Saturday. Now, if you, for some reason, you're traveling or you have something to do and you can't start on that specific day, that's not a problem. You can start somewhere around the same time as us, or maybe at a different time altogether. It's not a problem. But I'm going to encourage the group to try to do this all at the same time, so we can encourage each other and I can answer questions for you guys, because I'm going to be doing it as well as at the same time. So Saturday, March 30th is the day that I recommend that we all start this together. Okay. And it's also a good time of the year to do this. We'll be 10 days into spring by that point, because spring starts around March 20th. And spring is ideally the best time to do some kind of detox. Especially from a Chinese medicine perspective, they always consider the spring to be the best time to do any kind of cleanse. So all winter long, you're eating more foods, heavier foods, maybe not as healthy as you normally would. So everything sort of builds up, and the spring is a great time to start lightening up and eating lighter foods and just clearing out the residue from the winter. So that's another reason why the spring is the best time to do it. Another reason that I'm wearing this green shirt right now is I wanted to just show that, you know, the spring is coming and it's a great time to do something like this. So in any case, it comes in a 10 or 28 day. As a group, I'm encouraging everyone to do it as a 10 day. But if you want to do the 28 day, that's totally okay too. Just, you know, I will give you guidance along the way. And what's also great about this, it comes with a 76-page downloadable PDF guide and also a recipe book. So you'll have plenty of tools to help you get through it. And they're all free and included with the program. Okay, so let's talk about ways that you can prepare for this. So if you're in and you think, yeah, I'm ready, I want to try this. So some things I want to mention to you, because it's going to be a specific way of eating during the cleanse, very clean. And I'm sure most of you have heard me talk about clean eating just being in the group in general. But this is a very specific way of eating. So if you're currently eating processed foods, a lot of sugar, alcohol, a lot of caffeine, dairy products, I would encourage you to start eliminating or reducing these things prior to the cleanse, because these are the things you're going to be eliminating during it. So if you start to remove them beforehand, you're going to have an easier transition into when we start. So someone's asking a question here, is detox keto and vegan friendly? Yes, it is. And I'm going to get into that in a few minutes about what's specifically in it, and how it can work well with whatever kind of diet that you're already doing. So yes, it is both of those things. So yeah, so cleaning up the diet, you know, reducing your alcohol, caffeine, sugar intake is really important prior. And also, if you're having any kind of digestive issues, especially constipation, you're going to want to get that handled prior to starting, because a big part of the cleanse is to eliminate efficiently and smoothly. And if you're already backed up, it's going to be even harder for you to move things out of your body. So if you are struggling with constipation, let me know prior and I will get you on maybe one or two supplements that will help you enhance that you're eliminating properly, so that by the time you start the cleanse, you're able to go to the bathroom no problem, and you're not going to have any extra sort of problems with it. Because, you know, if you're trying to do a detox and everything's flooding into your system and trying to get out and you're not moving your bowels, it's only going to make the process a little bit more difficult. So I would encourage you to work on any issues with constipation prior to starting. Okay, so let's get into what exactly the program entails. So the program is called, it's a standard process, that's the company, Detox Balance. And they just came out with this, I believe it was last year or sometime. So it's basically a smoothie mix. I have a canister here at home, okay? I haven't done it completely as a 10 or 28 day. I just took it home so I could try it out and use it as a regular smoothie mix. So I've had it quite a few times, but not as a cleanse. I've just used it as a protein powder here and there. So this is what it looks like. And for the 10-day detox, you would get just one of these containers. And if you were to do the 28-day, you would get three of them. And basically you start out, it's a gradual progression. So you start out with one shake per day and you work your way up to three, and then you come back down to one. So it like helps you build up to the full amount and then back down again. So if you're doing intermittent fasting or any kind of fasting for that matter, it still will work with your program, not a problem at all. So in other words, if it were to say that you have to do three shakes that day, you could just divide the amount of scoops that you need into two and then just do two shakes per day, but just make the amount a little bit higher. And if you're doing one time a day, same thing, you could just do it all at one time. So if you're doing like a 24-hour fast that week, not a problem. You would just do the entire amount into that one meal. So it is totally compatible with any kind of intermittent fasting. So that's a good thing too. And if you are already doing intermittent fasting, I would encourage you to continue doing that during the cleanse, because intermittent fasting in and of itself is a great way to help the detoxification process. So we have another question. Can I add any other ingredients to the shake? Yes, of course. So you can just do it as is and add like coconut milk or water and get it down. Or if you want to make it into more of like a meal replacement, you can definitely add other things like frozen berries, avocado, et cetera, et cetera. And like I said before, it comes with a recipe book. So you'll have guidance on some ideas of ways that you can make the smoothies taste different. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about some of the foods that you are encouraged to eat during the cleanse. So obviously, vegetables are very, you know, important, and they help with the detoxification process anyway. So during the cleanse, you're encouraged to eat as many vegetables as you want. Fruit is okay too, but if you're doing low carb keto or you have blood sugar issues, you want to keep your fruit at a minimum, and you want to do low glycemic fruits. So you don't want to do a lot of bananas and sweet types of fruits like that. You might want to stick to berries. So it's flexible in that regard, but fruit is okay. Now, they say in the guide that you can have some whole grains and beans. Again, if you're doing keto or intermittent fasting or low carb, that's optional. You don't have to do quinoa or beans if you don't want to. But for those of you who are not quite at that level and you're already eating those kinds of foods, you can continue eating them. But like I said, if you're trying to keep to a low carb or trying to lose even more weight, I would recommend that you don't necessarily eat a lot of things in that specific category. What's also great about this particular cleanse is it allows animal protein. In the past, their other program recommended that you had no animal protein for the first 11 days. But with this one, they tell you that you can have clean animal protein right from the start. So that's great. So, and I was always encouraging people anyway, when they did the 21 day, to have animal protein right from the beginning. So I never really changed it myself. So organic, of course, is going to be critical if you're going to use any type of animal products. So if you're eating clean proteins, you know, meat, fish, chicken, even eggs are okay. In the last cleanse that they had, eggs were told to stay out. But on this one, eggs are not a problem. So you're going to have, you know, enough protein for the day. And in the guide, it's actually going to tell you exactly how many grams of protein that you need to have for your particular body weight, because that's really important when you're doing this cleanse, is to make sure you're getting enough protein. And the cool part is, in the shake itself, the two scoops for the shake are 17 grams of vegetarian protein. So if you're a vegetarian or vegan, no problems there. And it's a pea protein, so it's a very clean source of protein. It's 17 grams. So that already gives you a pretty decent amount of protein right in the shake itself. Okay. Let's see. So you're also allowed to eat seeds of any kind. So like chia seed, flax seed. They do recommend that you stay off nuts during the cleanse. A lot of people have sensitivity to nuts, and they can be difficult to digest, especially if they're not soaked. So they encourage you not to have nuts during the cleanse. So if you're an almond milk drinker, you might want to switch to a different kind of milk during the cleanse. You can do coconut milk, you can do hemp milk, and stuff like that, okay? So nuts are one thing that they don't want you to have. Other things that are going to be out during the cleanse, like I mentioned before, no alcohol during the cleanse. If you're doing a lot of coffee, I would highly recommend that you lower the amount that you're doing gradually prior, and then maybe switching to green tea, and then maybe maxing out at maybe one cup per day. Because ideally, they don't want you to have any caffeine at all, but I know for most people, that's not happening. So if you're strong-willed and you can do it, then go for it. But if you feel like you need to have just a little bit, then I would say switch to green tea and just do that as your caffeine source. Dairy is off for the entire time. Processed foods, you know, you want to stick to whole foods. Corn and potatoes, not during the cleanse. You can do sweet potatoes, but not white potatoes. And that's pretty much it. Of course, gluten is out. You can have non-gluten stuff like quinoa, buckwheat and things like that, but regular gluten products are out. They even say you can have a little bit of brown rice if you want to. Like I said, if you're doing low carb, maybe not. I have another question here. Will I notice any side effects during detox? That really depends. So if you've done cleanses before, if you're a seasoned faster, if you eat really healthy most of the time, probably not. But if you're new to detoxing, if you have a lot of health issues, there are potential side effects that may occur, especially in the beginning. And that's why they sort of ramp up the amounts of shakes that you're having. They're starting from one per day up to three so that your body can get used to it and not just completely start flooding your system with toxins. So yeah, side effects are possible. It's not going to be anything that dramatic. It might just mean like a little bit of a headache or fatigue, things like that. It's nothing too dramatic, but they usually will subside over the first couple of days. So like I said, if you prepare for the cleanse beforehand by eating a healthier diet and cutting out some of the junk beforehand, it's going to be a lot easier while you're doing it, okay? So if you're prone to having side effects, then I would say do more preparation beforehand and your chances of having side effects are really small. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about the smoothie itself. It only comes in one flavor. Hopefully in the future they'll make other flavors. This one is a chai flavor, so you know, it's not, you know, some people don't like the chai flavor. Some people can mask it really well with the other things that they put in there. So it's really up to you how you go about doing that. Like I said, you can add other things to it to give it a different taste, or you could just use it as is. It's totally up to you. But anyway, it's one serving, which is two scoops, is 17 grams of vegetarian protein. And it's with the fiber added in, it's only 7 grams of carbohydrates. So that's what makes it low carb and keto friendly, which is great. So you don't have to worry about having all these extra carbs because there, you know, since it's vegetarian, there are fruits and vegetables in the smoothie mix itself. Healthy stuff, of course, but there is carbohydrate in it. It's not completely carb free. It has things like pea protein and pumpkin, flax, apple pectin, Spanish black radish, buckwheat, carrot. So there's a bunch of things, foods basically, all foods that enhance the detoxification process, that help your body eliminate more efficiently, keep your bowels moving. So there's fiber in there. You don't have to take any extra fiber, which is great as well. So like I said, it comes with a 76 page guide, and that will be, I will either put that in the group that you could download directly, or if you're not in the group and you shared this, we can email it to send you the links. All of this stuff is already on Standard Process's website, but I will have the links to the guide and the recipe book available for you either in this group or in the description below or in the comments below. So you will get everything that you need from us. So the 10-day detox balance, okay, so do the 10-day program, is $85. And like I said, it includes just the one canister plus your guides. The 28-day, which probably less of you are going to do, is about $250. That's three canisters, the guides, and then also comes with actually a shaker bottle so that you can take your shakes on the go with you if you need to. So if you're interested in doing this, we highly encourage you to do it because it's springtime, because it's another weight loss tool, because you will feel better, and it's a good thing to do on a once a year basis just for good health and prevention of things down the line. So we really recommend that you do it. Now, 10 days is really not that long of a period of time. Beforehand, we were using their other program, and we still do use it. That was 21 days, and that was a really nice length of time. So 10 days, I think, is a little bit on the short side, but I feel that compliance will be really great because people can do anything for 10 days. It's a very short period of time. So if you want to do the 10 and maybe do another 10 after that, if you're feeling really good or you feel like you need more, that's totally okay too. But as a group, like I said, I'm going to try to encourage everyone to do this together as a 10-day starting on March 30th, which is a Saturday, okay? So if you're interested, get in touch with us any way that you can. Call the office, 609-736-0510. You can put a message in the comments here, and I will contact you directly there. You can send me an email. I'm going to put this out in our newsletter on Monday, so you'll get it in the newsletter. So those are the main ways. So just let us know that you're interested. And if you're local, if you're already a patient, you could pick it up at the office. Or if you live nearby, you can pick it up at either Summers Point or our office in Turnersville. If you don't live nearby, not a problem. We can ship it to you. And I highly encourage people to do the toxicity questionnaire beforehand so we can see exactly what your number is and see if we recommend the 10 or the 28 day, or just so you have some idea of how many symptoms of toxicity you actually have without realizing it. And then you could take it again when you're done and see if anything has gotten better, okay? So I will put a link to the toxicity questionnaire, again, either in the comments here or somewhere within the group. So if you know anybody else that might be interested in doing this, you know, do it as a family, do it with your friends. And of course, I encourage you to do it together with us. We're all going to be doing it at my office, my entire staff. We're all going to be starting it at the same time. And like I said, it's really easy. It's 10 days. Just eat clean. That's half of the detox right there, just having a really good diet. And the other half is the smoothie that has all of the supplements and things that you need in it. Whereas in the past, with the 21-day program, you had to not only do the shakes, you had to take a lot of pills during it. I mean, it's a very intense program, the 21-day, and it's I would say it's a little bit more detoxifying than this, but it's also a lot harder for people, and the compliance level seems to drop down because it's so many pills to take. So I'm interested in other types of supplements. How can I order? Contact the office. So yes, please get in touch with us if you need to prepare for the cleanse. Like if you're having trouble with constipation, let us know and we'll get you on a particular product or two that's going to help you move things out better. And then also, there's a product that we can give you for during the cleanse that will help with any type of side effects that you might have during. It's an herbal formula that has things like milk thistle in it, which are really good for your liver and to protect it, that will keep the side effects to a minimum if you know that you're prone to that. So I know there aren't that many people on the call because this was spontaneous, so I don't expect a lot of questions. But if you guys have any questions, anybody who's still there, please chime in now. If not, if you're watching this on the replay, please post your questions in the comment section below, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube. Post your questions and I will answer them as soon as possible. And I hope you guys consider doing this. If you're stuck in a weight loss plateau, this is a really great way to get unstuck, because when you start to eliminate things that have been building up, it's a really good way to reset your hormones. So cleaning out the liver can really help with your hormones. Hormones meaning thyroid, adrenals, sex hormones like estrogen, testosterone, all of that. So cleaning out your liver is a really good way to enhance your metabolism overall. So if you're at a plateau with your weight loss, I highly encourage that you do this. And if you're not already intermittent fasting, of course, I encourage you to do that as well. And if you combine the two, that makes it even better, okay? So let me just do a quick summary of everything that we went over, since I don't see anybody chiming in with any more questions. So what detoxification is, something that we're doing naturally, but we're overburdened with the amount of chemicals that we have in our body. So we're not eliminating the toxins as efficiently as we could be. Otherwise, we'd be walking around really healthy all the time, and we're not. And we're getting symptoms from it. We're exposed to over 80,000 chemicals every single day, from the air, the water, the products that we use. We live in a very toxic world. So it's really important that we get everything out. Doing it on a regular basis, at least once a year, is a great way to do that. Other ways to detox are fasting, exercise, heat therapy, taking herbal supplements. This program, it helps kidney, colon, and liver all at the same time. So it's a really good, quick, easy way to help with the elimination process. To prepare, you're just going to eat a clean diet prior. Make sure that you're eliminating already. You get to have 1 to 3 shakes per day over the course of 10 or 28 days. You're going to be eating really clean during the detox, and you're going to be eliminating certain foods during that time, which is a good thing anyway. And again, it comes with PDF guides, digital guides, 76-page book, and a recipe book. Okay? Call us, message us, email us, let us know if you want to get in on the cleanse. We're starting this as a group on Saturday, March 28th for 10 days. All right, guys, I will keep this one short and sweet, and hope you enjoy the rest of your Sunday afternoon. And I look forward to doing the 10-day detox with everybody. All right, so have a great day. If there aren't any more questions, I'm gonna get out of here and see you guys soon. All right. Thanks, guys. Take care.